the other side of things now, the Eagles. They're 0-2, guys. DeMarco out of shotgun. It's not working on 18 of his 21 plays. He had just 2 yards. Bradford can't throw downfield. Stephen A., you just said they're done, but how much trouble is this Eagles team really in?
They're god-awful. Let's just call it what it is. They're a soft team. Mm-hmm. The Philadelphia Eagles are a soft football team. And it's all the fault of Chip Kelly. All of it. First of all, DeMarco Murray is an eye back. He's a north and south runner. Why do you have him running sideways? Now, you want to blame DeMarco Murray? Fine, because it looks like he was stupid for going to the Philadelphia Eagles. Mm-hmm. Because you got to know what Chip Kelly is doing. Mm-hmm. But Chip Kelly is supposed to be the brainiest. He's completely misusing DeMarco Murray. Mm-hmm. And I applaud DeMarco Murray's heart. He was out there fighting yesterday. Now, granted, he wasn't getting any blocking from his... I mean, Barbary and Gardner and these boys, they didn't do anything. I mean, that offense, every time DeMarco Murray touched the ball, he had a hand on him before he could even make a move. They were not blocking for him at all. The offensive line was absolutely horrific and pathetic and inept, okay? They should be ashamed of how they performed. They should give money back for the way that they performed yesterday. That's number one. Number two, you let go of Jeremy Maclin, your number one wide receiver from last year. Skip, I really, really like Jordan Matthews. There's no question about it. But he's relatively young. He's a great number two receiver at this juncture. He's destined to be a number one. He has no business being your number one guy right now. Riley Cooper has no business being on that roster. All he could do is block, okay? And right now, he'd be a better offensive lineman than the offensive lineman they have, as awful as they have been. Mm-hmm. That's point number three. Point number four, Sam Bradford. Lord. I mean, he's got a worse passer rating than Nick Foles. He's got a worse passing rating than Johnny Manziel, even though Johnny Manziel's passer rating is better than a lot of quarterbacks in the NFL over the first 2 weeks of this season. I'm just looking at Sam Bradford right now. He looked like a deer in headlights. He looked petrified and scared to death at what Dallas was throwing at him. He seemed confused. He didn't seem to have that dog in him that you would want from somebody playing for Philadelphia, where you got to be a rough rider, you got to go after it, and you got to sit there and get feisty and be willing to fight. It's one of those, this is football we're talking about here. And don't tell me that the Dallas Cowboys didn't look in that dude's eyes and see somebody that was scared to death. Like I tweeted, he looked like a cat at a dog show, for crying out loud. Petrified of what was coming his way. It was really pathetic and how sadly bad Sam Bradford was. And so when I take all of those things into consideration, I'm looking at it from the perspective, Skip Bayless, that even though the Eagles have talent, and individually, they got some cats on their squad that can play for anybody. Collectively speaking, as they've been put together by Chip Kelly, they seem relatively inept. 5 of these 8 are the first 8 quarters of this NFL season. They have not scored a point. Not a single point in 5 of the 8 quarters. Don't give me the touchdown they scored last night. That was straight garbage. That was garbage time. Nobody's paying attention to that. So when you look at the Philadelphia Eagles right now, their running attack, their passing attack, their protection at the line of scrimmage, it just doesn't seem to be there. And Chip Kelly is one of these guys. I mean, the arrogance is on an all-time high, because I haven't seen too many coaches in all my years of watching the NFL who believe wholeheartedly in their system so much that they don't need talent. We've got a system-style coach in Bill Belichick, but he recognizes that he can make modifications because he has Tom Brady. So at least he made sure he had talent somewhere. Chip Kelly is like, yeah, I need what I need. I ain't worried about talent. We got this covered because I know what I'm doing. And it's embarrassing. I worked in Philadelphia for almost 17 years. And there is at no time does that city look more or resemble more of a morgue than when it loses to the Dallas Cowboys. So that's bad enough. But to lose to Dallas in this fashion, where you just seemed ill-equipped to even be on the same field as them, is so incredibly embarrassing.
With no Dez, no Romo.
No Dez, no Romo.
And all those under.
Just embarrassing. There's no excuse for it, Skip. None.
First on Sam Bradford. You will attest, I first guessed this one.
Oh, no,
I'm not second guessing. I first guessed.
I didn't guess against. I would say this. I didn't get a guess against you because I didn't know.
Okay.
I watched him in St. Louis. I knew he could throw the football, but I didn't watch him intimately enough to measure his heart. You have been watching him since his days in college, and you've always questioned his heart. I got to admit to you, I think his nickname should be Tin Man right now. Mm-hmm. I got a lot of questions about Sam Bradford after yesterday's performance. I really do.
As you know, I'm a University of Oklahoma fan, mm-hmm. born and raised. I watched every snap Sam Bradford took in college, and I made a big statement on this show. St. Louis is making a huge mistake to take him number one overall. And remember what they had to do before the rookie cap kicked in? They had to give him $50 million guaranteed in St. Louis. And then I went on record when Chip traded for him. I said, Chip is making a big mistake because, to your point, Chip wants to be the star of the show. Sam Bradford is the ultimate cog quarterback, the ultimate sort of, you know, extension of the coach on the football field. If you get your fast break offense going and you get on a roll, he can throw darts. If it starts to go just a little bit south, he will fold up, and he does not have the dynamic personality or body language or playmaking skills to reverse momentum for right. you. He's not going to make that play that changes the game. In fact, I would suggest to you that his body language is at least as bad as Jay Cutler's is. Did you see Bradford yesterday?
Yeah.
Does he not hang his head fast? Teammates are looking at him like, seriously? You got to help us.
You got to fire us up. You're getting no argument from me.
You're getting no argument from me there. Okay, so he's the wrong guy at the wrong place at the wrong time for a football team that went out and got a power back for a spread option geared offense. How did Philadelphia kill the Cowboys on Thanksgiving night at Jerry World with the spread option?
That's right.
I think they ran it eight times with Mark Sanchez because Mark Sanchez has some athletic ability. And he kept the ball several times and just gashed him. And LeSean McCoy can make you miss at the line
of
scrimmage.
He's
slippery. DeMarco is not slippery. The great stat is last year in Dallas, DeMarco mm-hmm. obviously led the league in rushing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
His first contact came an average of 2.8 yards down the field. Yeah. In Philly so far, where he has, what's his total so far? 11 yards on 21 tries. He's been getting hit slightly behind the line of scrimmage with first contact. He's not going to make that guy miss. It's not that he's going to go straight down, but it's going to slow him up because the guy will get him around the ankles, and then the avalanche is going to fall in on him. So he's not the right guy for what you're trying to do if you're not going to run the spread option. Have you seen him run it one time with Sam Bradford? I've not seen any. I might have missed one, but I think they've gotten away from what they do because they've tried to cater to what DeMarco did in Dallas, and they're not the Dallas Cowboys. So this is a bad fit. And the only solution here is, I guess, they'd have to go to your guy, Mark Sanchez.
I feel bad for DeMarco yesterday.
As I tweeted yesterday, because I tweeted a lot yesterday, I tweeted that they should have benched Bradford and put in Mark Sanchez. Mm-hmm. That's point number one. Point number two, just as an aside, when they decided to throw, when they were on the goal line, first pass incomplete, second pass interception by Sean Lee, and no time did they try to run the football. DeMarco Murray, very moderate, you know, not demonstrative or bombastic in any way, is screaming at the sidelines, why, and going off. Had that been LeSean McCoy or DeSean Jackson or somebody, we would have heard a whole bunch of stuff about it. So maybe it's not about DeMarco Murray. Maybe it wasn't about those dudes. Maybe it's about some of the decisions that Chip Kelly is making. That's point number two. Point number three, Byron Maxwell might be able to play. He was a member of the Legion of Boom.
Yeah.
He is no number one cover corner. Can we at least concede that?
He had a long day yesterday.
He had a long day yesterday, and there was no Dez Bryant on the field, and he had a long day. Mm-hmm. That 42-yard touchdown from Whedon, not Romo, Whedon to
stay
Terrence Williams.
Stay off the Whedon?
I'm not saying stay on the Whedon. You got to stay on the Whedon right now. But the point that I'm trying to make to you is this. That pass, did you see the effort? Slant pattern, Terrence Williams,
and Byron Maxwell,
oh, you got me. And I'm just sitting there like this. This brother just got $60 million now, and I'm looking at it from the perspective of number one game of the season, meaning week one. The Atlanta Falcons are playing the Philadelphia Eagles. Who's the head coach of the Atlanta Falcons? That's Mr. Dan Quinn. Who's the former defensive coordinator last year from Seattle? Dan Quinn. You think it's an accident that Dan Quinn went after Byron Maxwell? You think that's an accident? I granted you got Julio Jones, one of the best of the game at wide receiver. Please don't get me wrong. But Dan Quinn was like, we don't go after this dude because he might have some insight into Byron Maxwell's cover ability. So all of those things taken into consideration. You got Chip Kelly. He paid $60 million to Byron Maxwell. He ain't showing up. Mm-hmm. You got rid of Evan Mathis, which, by the way, you reneged because you said that you were planning to pump up the back end of his contract. Did. Then you rescinded that offer, which is what upset Mathis. And you decide to let him go, knowing that you were going to need him on your offensive line. We ain't even getting into Macklin, DeSean Jackson, LeSean McCoy. Just the moves that you've made, this team, as far as I'm concerned, does not look like a team. It looks like a compilation of what Chip Kelly wants and is trying to make into a team.
Yep.
As opposed to it actually being a team. And that is what I believe cost them. And that's what I saw yesterday. And that's why I said, you know what? Eagles are toast.
And you know what? Last point. When things do go south in Philly, I don't think Chip has built up a reservoir of love in that locker room that you can fall back on. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Once it starts to go, they're like, wait a second.
Yeah.
They're going to win their share of games. But the aura that they had attached to them coming into the season, now we're remembering, wait a minute, this dude never won a national championship. Mm. And on a professional level, yeah, you went to the playoffs your first year. You finished both 10-6 both years, but you weren't in the playoffs last year. So suddenly we're looking at Chip Kelly the way maybe we should have looked at him all along. The man knows football. Mm-hmm. The man can coach. But his ego and his desire for more power may have gotten in the way of his responsibilities as a coach. And I think that it's coming home to roost right now.
Yeah, the pressure's really on for Philly to win this week in New York at the Jets. History not on their side. If they lose, over 25 years, only three teams that started 0-3 have made it to the playoffs.